motor running. Head out on the highway. Looking for adventure. And whatever comes our way. Yeah, I gotta go make it happen. Take the world in a loving place. Fire all of the guns across the sun. Explode into space. I like smoking lightning. Racing with the wind, and the feeling that I'm good. Yeah, I gotta go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. Fire all of the guns and bullets and explode into space. Like a true nature's child, we were born, born to be wild. We can fly so high. I never wanna die.
Hi, I'm QDC. What we're about to build today is Miniart's Harley Davidson motorcycle, and this is 1/35th scale. In my opinion, I think World War II really helped Harley Davidson a lot. It helped the company really take off as it is today, as you know it as Harley Davidson as it is today. Before World War II, Harley Davidson was a very small motorcycle company, and when the war broke out, the military needed motorcycles, and so they asked Harley Davidson to create 60,000 motorcycles for the military, and they did. What happened was that when these servicemen were trained to ride motorcycles during the Second World War, they found out that riding a motorcycle was a lot of fun. And so when the war was over, these servicemen wanted to have a motorcycle for themselves at home to enjoy. And that's when the craze of motorcycle riding really began, in my personal opinion. And also movies, Hollywood movies such as The Wild Ones and Easy Rider also perpetuated the motorcycle genre for people to ride motorcycles, and also created its own lifestyle as well. So this is going to be a good model kit for me to build, and hopefully you get to enjoy it too. So let's go ahead and start building this kit right now. Let's go take a look inside this box. We have one plastic bag containing all the parts. And the instruction sheet. We're going to also build the Allied road signs World War II by Miniart. And so this kit contains one plastic bag containing parts for the road sign and the decal. I want to talk to you about making the wheels. Miniart has really decided that making the wheels should not be made entirely out of plastic, but a combination of plastic and photo etch part. In this envelope is the photo etch part. Right over here. And as you can see, these four parts right here are the wheels. They're very nice spokes right here, and they look pretty realistic. Now, the wheels does have a curvature to it, and so Miniart has also created a jig for you. Right over here that I'm pointing at. You're supposed to take out the wheel from the fret, put it onto this jig, and then with the other part of the jig, press it right down like that in order for you to make the curvature of the wheel. And I think this is one of the most ingenious parts of Miniart's design for this model kit. And I think this is also the best feature of this model kit as well. I'm going to make the wheel. So this is the jig. This is the wheel. I'm going to put the wheel on top of the jig, like so. Then, with the other half of the jig, I'm going to put that right on top, like that, and then press down. Like that. Now, this is the finished product. And I'm not quite sure you can see this, but there is a curvature in this wheel. It's no longer flat. I want to talk to you about a repair that I've done. There is a part that is warped, so when I put on this luggage rack, I found out that it wasn't perfectly straight, and so I had to add a piece of white plastic to compensate. It's time for me to build the baskets for the front wheel. Miniart requires me to actually make those baskets out of photo etch part. What you're looking at right now is a jig to make the part. And right here in my right hand is the actual photo etch part. So I put the photo etch part onto the jig, like so, and then press down to make the actual shape that I need to build the basket. All right, so we built a model kit, and now it's time for me to show you what I think about this kit so far. Take a look.
This is the completed model kit before painting. And this is a very detailed model kit for the scale. The best parts of this model kit are the photo etch parts, especially the spokes on the wheels. They look very realistic, and the control shifts right here looks pretty nice as well. There are a lot of small, detailed, delicate parts that make up this model kit, and this model kit is not meant for the beginner. If you're a beginner, you will not be able to build this model kit because it's just too intricate and too delicate for you to make. So I recommend this model kit for the intermediate and for the advanced modeler only. I want to go off on a tangent. I know there's some viewers that are motorcyclists, and you probably noticed that I own a small motorcycle. And for Americans in the United States, most people own large motorcycles. Believe it or not, I used to be an avid motorcycle rider, and I own many large motorcycles. And the last one that I owned was a Kawasaki KZ1000 police motorcycle. Geez, I just revealed my age. But anyway, that was a very fun bike. And that police motorcycle, I unintentionally scared a lot of people. But anyway, I used to be an avid motorcycle rider, but as I grew older, my interest in motorcycle riding began to fade away. I got married, and I didn't think that riding motorcycles was being a responsible married man. So I decided to get rid of my motorcycles and just continue on with my life. Then, as time passed, I miss riding motorcycles, so I decided to buy a new motorcycle. But I didn't want to own a large motorcycle like I did in my youth, because I didn't want to ride as often as I used to, just occasionally. So I got that small little motorcycle that you see that I have right now. It's a fun little motorcycle, and I really do enjoy riding that little thing. Enough of me. It's time for me to paint the model. It's time for me to paint the model. I already gave the entire model a coat of black primer, and now I'm going to use my airbrush and start painting the main color. I just finished painting the color for the motorcycle, and I want to talk to you more about the actual colors that I used. When you look at the motorcycle, you see there's only one color, olive drab, but in reality there's four colors. Now, when light hits an object, it creates shadows and highlights. So I use black, the actual primer, to actually use that as a shadow. Then I use the base color, which is this color I'm pointing at right here, to paint the entire model. Then I changed it to this lighter color, the highlight, to give certain parts of the model to have highlights. And then right over here, I gave it bright highlights, this color that I'm pointing at right now, just to give us some highlights on some parts of the motorcycle. And use all four colors, including the black, to make the model look as it is right now.
it's time for me to build a diorama. What you see right here is a wooden plaque base that I bought at my local craft store, and I gave it a nice stain. Now I'm going to put the ground material by adding tile grout. I just made this building wall, and it wasn't hard to build at all. It's made out of two styrofoam boards that I cut and made into size, and then I covered it with plaster of Paris. I just finished completing this sign, and this kit from Miniart is actually pretty good. It's very easy. It's just two parts for this particular sign, but the best part about this kit is the decal. I expected to have just like a piece of paper for me to glue onto the plastic, but this kit does have a real decal set, like the ones you would normally see for other model kits. And that would make this particular kit salt outstanding to me. I like it. Okay, so we built the model kit, we painted it, we weathered it, and we even made a small diorama out of it. So now it's time for me to show you the entire model kit from the beginning to the end. Take a look. This is the completed model kit after building, painting, and creating the entire diorama. And I think this is one of the better dioramas that I have built so far up to date. The model kit for the motorcycle is, again, really superb. It's just highly detailed.
And this sign made by Miniart gives this entire model a very nice, distinctive, unique appearance. And also my scratch-built building and adding the rubble for this diorama gives it a nice appearance. I really do like this diorama a lot, and the Miniart motorcycle is just superb. I want to go off on a tangent. When I was making this video, I began to realize that I might be giving you, the viewer, a false message about motorcycling. So I want to make myself clear that I do not want anyone to ride a motorcycle. Again, I do not want anyone to ride a motorcycle. And the reason why is because motorcycling is an inherently dangerous sport. Although motorcycling is fun, there are a lot of dangers about riding motorcycles. And you must understand about the dangers of motorcycling as well before you even ride a motorcycle. Now, I've been riding motorcycles for a very long time, and I did not have any accidents on a motorcycle yet. And how I so far haven't gotten myself into an accident is because I'm a very careful rider. So for those of you who are even remotely interested in riding a motorcycle, I really suggest that you should see the other side of motorcycling, about the motorcycle accidents that you may get yourself involved in. So at the end of this video, I'm going to include a link for you to watch for those of you who are interested in riding motorcycles. It's a compilation of motorcycle accidents. If you could watch this video and see the other side of motorcycle riding, to see the accidents, then if you're willing to accept these incidents that may happen to you, then maybe motorcycle riding may be the right thing. If it is, then I would highly recommend taking a motorcycle safety course. Motorcycle safety courses are an essential part of motorcycle riding, in my opinion. And I think it'll keep you alive if you decide to ride a motorcycle. Okay, so right now we're at my local Harley Davidson repair shop. I brought my bike over here for repairs, and they're willing to actually do some repairs for my bike to service it. But anyway, that completes this model project. What you're about to see is a video slideshow of this entire model kit. But before I go, as always, just because I put this video here on YouTube, it doesn't make me a model kit expert. I am not an expert. I'm just a regular guy just like you. So please, build a model kit of your own and enjoy it. I'm QDC, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
the Army and proud of our name. We're the Army and proudly proclaim. First to fight for the right and to build the nation's might. And the Army goes rolling along. Proud of all we have done, fighting till the battle's won. And the Army goes rolling along. And it's high, high day, the Army's on its way. Cages out its door. For wherever we go, you will always know that the Army goes.